What's up, guys? Dreadmere here. Childish Gambino has been talk of the town recently. He's been like hot in the streets because his new video dropped a week ago, This Is America, and everybody loves it. Not necessarily because of the song or how catchy it is or anything like that. I've heard very few tweets and comments about how good the song is, but because, oh my god, it's so deep. And I must be missing something. I have to be missing something, right? Because I just don't see anything deep about this video. I don't get what the fuck. What is so deep about this video that I guess I'm just not getting? There are a ton of breakdowns about this music video online, and not just by some black guy, but by NBC, by Vice. Like, these are huge news sources and people talking about this video and experts who are, I guess, experts in like music theory or something, like all this dumb shit, talking about how deep the video is and how the music and the lyrics and the imagery and choreography and everything, it all leads up to this huge or portrays this huge message throughout the video. So in the opening part of this video, you have Childish Gambino dancing and all this kind of stuff, and it leads up to this part where he shoots somebody in the back of the head. And then after he shoots them, they drag the body away carelessly, and then they gingerly put the gun that he used on a pillow, and then some like fuckboy in a white, like all white, like waiter suits or concierge suit carries it away delicately. And oh my god, you may not have noticed that the first time you saw the video. But the message here that everybody seems to agree on that is so deep is that we treat guns better than people, that we hold guns to this high standard and people are just tossed aside like nothing. I don't really understand what's deep about that, because it kind of sounds exactly like what all these NRA and gun activists are saying. It's like the same thing, right? They're saying, my gun equals my life. My gun is how I protect my life. Without that, I don't have any way to live. The other way to look at it is that because it was a black person that Gambino shot, that we're saying that guns are more important than black people in particular. Specifically, black people's lives are unimportant, and we just drag them away, like whatever, and then guns we take care of. I also don't agree with that, because we did just have a movement, or are still having a movement for years, called Black Lives Matter. That's what it was called. My point is, we have been talking about this. I don't see why people are saying, oh, thank God. Oh my God, finally somebody is bringing attention to this. I don't see it. I don't see it that way. Later on in the video, he does the same thing where he's in a church and there's an all-black choir singing and having a good time, and then he comes in and then he shoots them. And that's very clearly, everyone seems to agree, that that's a callback to the Charleston shooting by Dylan Roof, who was a white supremacist, which again, is not very deep. That's very literal. That's very literally, this is what happens, and this is America, is I guess what he's saying, right? Like, this kind of shit is happening, which has had a lot of attention brought to it. This isn't some obscure news story that got skirted under the rug that nobody ever knew about or talked about. This was a huge fucking deal. What am I supposed to get out of this that I don't already... What is the deeper thing that I don't already know? I'm confused. Another thing that people are blown away by are his poses throughout the video. He does some, like, Jim Crow poses, which I don't really see what is deep about that either. Like, I guess having a callback to historical arts and all that kind of stuff is a nice touch. Interesting, maybe, but it's not deep. It's certainly not deep. There's nothing deep about Jim Crow. Is it because all these news articles and all these people are saying, oh, you may not have noticed this, so everybody has to jump on and say, oh, no, I saw, that's, oh, hell yeah, that's, no, I saw, I'm super woke. I knew immediately that that shit was Jim Crow. I knew that that shit was because guns are bad, and I knew that that shit is because black people are treated unfairly. If those are all the main points of the video, I don't really see what the fuck, like, what is so deep about it? What is deep about saying any of these things? Guns are bad, right? Is that, have you... If you were at a party and then some guy was like, you know, dude, I'm starting to think guns are just not good for society in general, would you be like, holy shit, dude, I think you're onto something? I think the other frustrating thing about this video is that I also don't see it that way. I don't see it like black people are just constantly attacked and hated. I just don't see it that way. I don't know what to tell you. Call me a fucking racist, but I don't agree. Now, I could say, oh, well, Black Panther just came out. That was one of the biggest fucking hits ever in all of movie history, and it was predominantly black. I think it might have been all black. And what, is that like a joke? Is that like all the racists who voted for Trump also went out to go see Black Panther? And that's like an inside joke amongst racists? Like, yeah, we're gonna give all this money to them because fuck them, right? Or I could also say that Michael Jackson was the biggest fucking pop star for decades, and he was also black. So celebrating hip-hop culture or black artists is not a new thing, and it's not ironic. I don't think it is. I never thought it was. But is that the message that this is saying? Is that like, we see black people both as targets, or we see black people both as dangerous, but also admire them. And that's the whole frustrating thing about this video, is like, everybody talks about the contrast. Oh my god, he's dancing and there's chaos and anarchy in the background. It's insane. What a great way to portray that. That's a very obvious way to talk about this. If that's the only thing that he wants from this, is just to hold up a mirror, right, to America. It's called This Is America, and just say, look, this is what I see. This is Donald Glover's perspective on what America looks like. Okay, fine. I guess that's a fine video to make. That's whatever. But is it deep? No, hell no. It's not. There's nothing deep about that. People seem to get really excited when they identify problems. They're like, oh my god, you're a genius. But nobody seems to really get excited when we're talking about principles, right? Case in point, Kanye West. Kanye West has been on the other side of the conversation. Nobody's championing him as a speaker for change. They're saying, oh, he's a fucking racist. He doesn't want to attack Trump like the rest of us. And because so many people are talking about it, of course there's the idea, well, you know, he has an album coming out. Oh, that's right! I forgot that everything has a dollar sign in front of it. I forgot that every person, item, and everything in the world, every idea and action you do has a dollar sign in front of it. Nobody cares about principles. When I don't really have a hard time believing that Kanye West does believe in his principles, that he does believe in individuality, he's always thought his ideas were better than everybody else's. Even if they weren't, even if I don't agree with them, it doesn't matter. He's always been this way. So I don't really see an inconsistency in him talking about these ideas, trying to agree with Trump, or trying to at least think on his own, and it all just being him reaching for attention because he's got an album coming out. I don't see it that way at all. So here you have Donald Glover doing a very basic, I guess, portrayal of what it's like to be black in America. A very specific portrayal of what it's like to be black in America for maybe certain people, I guess, but it's not, that's not, this is America? This is the way you see it? That it's just, it's only this way. Now the weirdest part about all of this for me is that I'm a fan of Donald Glover. I've listened to his music for years. I'm a huge fan. Because I'm white. But I don't think all of these ideas about police brutality and how black people are constantly targeted are simply because they're black. And that's the only reason. We just still hate black people. That's all there is to it. It's just because of that. That's a very unimpressive and unintellectual way to look at things, I think. You don't think that maybe some of this police brutality or maybe some of these things that are going on are because of the tensions that have risen so high because people are constantly saying that cops are gonna shoot anybody always because they're just fucking crazy, or every single one of them? You don't think that maybe the tensions are rising because everybody's constantly telling black people that they're targets, that they should always look over their shoulder because police want to shoot them for any reason at any given moment? And this is constantly being told to us. I know, because even I feel nervous. I feel nervous when a cop pulls me over or if I'm around cops. And again, I'm white. Like I don't know what to tell you, dude. Like, entertainment is a good thing. I don't agree that entertainment is distracting us from the real problems. I don't agree that black people are all barcodes and that's just how everybody sees it. And I don't agree that somebody or some people can tell me that that's how I feel, because I don't. This is just another way for people to tell you to feel guilty and to feel shitty about yourself, and there's nothing you can do about it. People are just naturally defective. That's what I hear all the time. People are just we shouldn't even have all this shit. If you talk to a lot of these SJWs, they say the same shit. We shouldn't even have all this stuff. We shouldn't even have electricity and buildings and just cities that are just right angles and cleanliness and all that kind of stuff. We should just be living in huts. That's what people are, because we're just animals, right? And I don't fucking agree. I don't know what to tell you. Like, I just don't see it that way. People can choose. As if we don't have agency over our own thought. As if we can't believe something and bring it into fruition. Kanye West must have a dollar sign in front of him. That's the only reason he's saying this dumb shit. He just wants to get more money. More fucking money. That's all it ever is. There's no such thing as principles. There's no such thing as something that people actually believe. There's never a person who wants to create and they're fine with just creating, even if it means they have to starve. I don't buy this narrative that when a black person gets shot for no reason, that nobody talks about it. That's the first thing people talk about. If a black person gets shot, the first conversation we have is, was it racially motivated? Was it because this person was black? Is that why he got shot? But then if you look at all these massacres, like in Vegas, where this guy is just literally shooting people, he's not a black guy, he's not targeting black people. So what are we talking about then? We're not talking about race, we're just talking about guns in general. Well, I guess guns are bad, right? And it sucks because I don't have anything to say about any of this political shit. I don't have anything to say about guns or about race. All I care about is principles. All I care about is where the stuff is downstream from. Philosophy. Where do you really think this comes from? Do you really think it's because somebody made a racist video at some point? You think it's because there were entire generations of racists, that this is why we have problems now? I don't see anything deep in talking about problems. I'm sorry. Very specific problems too. But if you want to hear something deep, why don't we talk about principles, right? Why don't we talk about principles as a better jumping off point than just problems? And if you don't agree that ideas or principles are more powerful motivation than any amount of money or any material thing, let me put it to you this way. How much money could I offer you to drive into a crowd of people, kill as many as possible, and blow the car up, including killing yourself? How much money do you think I could offer you to do that? $100,000? $1 million? Could I offer you Kanye West's $50 million mansion or whatever the fuck? Would you take it? Would you take that deal? Would you say, yeah, I'll kill myself if I get the mansion? Probably not, right? Probably not, because you're dead. And that's just an idea. That's not something you can see. That's not something you can have. That's just something that they're given. They're given this idea that if they kill themselves, they're gonna get a return later. Ideas are powerful. I don't know how else to say that. Ideas are way more powerful than these specific actions. And if I look at both of these cases, you have Donald Glover talking about very specific incidences and maybe making the point that people aren't talking about them, which we are. And you have Kanye West talking about ideas, talking about individuality, talking about freedom of thought and not using groupthink to lazily make all your decisions for you. But I think that America has it backwards. I think the rest of the world has it backwards. We're very, very lost.